gentlemen. I'm very happy to announce that we both were adults when we saw Kuch Kuch Hota Hai. Yes, people above 18 also did see the film. And evidently, a lot of them are here today as well.
In life, there are some equations you make and some that you are born into. We were lucky to have inherited Yash Uncle, Hiru Auntie, Karan, and now Ruhi and Yash Jr. Very few men have the distinction of being known for their generosity, professionalism, friendship, while still being universally loved. In some, one is hard-pressed to find even one of these qualities. Yash Uncle possessed them all. I will forever remember him with his shock of white hair, his kind face, briefcase in hand, dashing in and out of the house whenever we went over.
When there were celebrations in our home, he was always the first to reach, dressed and on time, asking what he could do to help. When there were occasions of sadness, he was the first to reach, and without asking, he would set himself to helping out. He was an indulgent father and a very indulgent producer, unabashedly proud of what his son had achieved.
I remember once walking with him in London. We were discussing dinner, but even in that conversation, and though it was out of context, he brought up his son, his immense vision, and equally immense extravagance.
Very much a man of the world, claimed by all, but his heart was his family's alone. In Karan, there is so much of his father. He never has to be asked, he's always there, on time, with his pout ready, asking how he can be of help. The tradition of dharma, duty, passed on seamlessly from father to son.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Kuch Kuch Hota Hai is one movie that my family throws on me when I suppose they run out of tomatoes or eggs. My mother once said, "Do you know what is the best part about Kuch Kuch Hota Hai?" And I said, "What, the songs?" And she said, "No, your absence." Then each time I tell my husband, "I think you should do this script and not that," he says, "Please, I don't need your advice. You're the person who said no to Kuch Kuch Hota Hai." But for that, I don't really have any excuse. In fact, I never felt bad about it till I was here today and I saw this AV and how many awards, and that, you know, I actually regretted saying no for the first time in my life. I do remember Karan coming to give me a narration of the script. It was the first narration he'd ever given anybody. And we were sitting in my grandmother's house. The ceiling was constantly leaking. And halfway through, I didn't know what was more damp, the ceiling or Karan's face, because he was crying profusely and I had to keep giving him one tissue after another. He was very touched by his own story. But needless to say, Karan didn't cry for very long. He already had the incredible Shah Rukh and Kajol, and then he found the terrific Rani Mukherjee, made this marvelous movie, and has been laughing all the way to the bank ever since. Now, Karan has claimed that I broke his heart when I didn't do this movie because he'd written the part for me, but I want to tell him that I did him the greatest favor, considering every movie I did, even with Shah Rukh Khan, bombed. Kuch Kuch Hota Hai is a super hit simply because I'm not in it. And Rani, my dear friend, I've told you this before, but you owe me a million gifts because, darling, I made your career.
As we all know, he's written his introduction himself. He has praised himself. He has made sure that we all know that there's no one better than him. But the truth is that we all absolutely know that there is no one better than him. So, of course, we're here to talk about a man who has an exceptional place in my heart, in my life, and, of course, the many, many WhatsApp groups. He's my partner in crime, in gossip, industry information. He's my go-to person for an emergency, for a fashion tip. I hope I'm looking okay, Karan. And of course, even amazing career advice that he's given me. I love him. The word that's written is not enough. I actually love him to death. And I really hope that he stops judging TV shows hosting talk shows and pretending that he's the Kim Kardashian of our country. If only he directed feature films, he would never leave the tat that he rightfully deserves. And of course, Apoorva, my eyes are actually on you, because I did mention this to Karan, that maybe in my old age, I will be the CEO of Dharma Productions.
It's her anniversary today, and she still took time out to come and do this. Thank you so much. Thank you. We love.
Yes, the most important part being Tom Uncle, Mr. Yash Johar, whose baby it was, whose dream it was, not only this film, very many before this and very many after this also. And some of them didn't do as well as you know, he must have wanted or desired or worked hard enough for. And that's one thing I learned from him, 27 years in the film industry now. And the one thing I learned from him is sometimes our best is not good enough, but that does not make you unrelenting or give up. So thank you, Mr. Yash Johar, for teaching me that lesson and giving us Kuch Kuch Hota Hai. Hero Auntie, who obviously is the strength behind this whole Dharma production, and Karan and Mr. Yash Johar, who will always sweetly, quietly keep playing cards, but we know where all the brains and intelligence in the family comes from. So thank you, and the sense of humor. So thank you, Hero Auntie, for being there. And I do remember, tum dekh lena, just before Kuch Kuch Hota, or a few days into the shooting, her wise words, because of which this film became what it became. She told me, "Dekh lena, Karan camera koi achhi jagah pe rakh le." So that's something I kept looking at while we were shooting, and that's why the film looks so beautiful, Hero Auntie. And of course, Karan. Why I did the film is I normally, even till date, and which might finally, ultimately, 75 years from now, lead to my downfall, that I never listen to scripts. I listen to the heartbeats of people that I work with. I've never understood a script. They are young actors, millennials, they're called, yeah. The millennials who sit with me sometimes chatting and say, "Sir, wo script aapne chhod di, kya kamal ki script thi?" Mujhe aaj tak script samajh hi nahi aayi koi. Aur main ye bahut dunke ki chot par keh sakta hoon. Dil pe haath rakh ke keh sakta hoon ki I've never understood the script. I've understood the script maker or the script filmmaker at the end of the whole many pages of dialogues and stuff. And when Karan came and narrated the film to me, I was shooting for a film called Chahat at Night. Alia's not here, I would like to tell her. I wanted to, great company Pooja was. I would have rather be sitting with Pooja and chatting that night. And Karan came and I told Tom
to that, but before that I have to ask Shah Rukh sir one question. I'm sorry to go off script. You know, when I saw Kuch Kuch Hota Hai, I would always wonder how would his hair look so wet in every scene. Then I would think, is it the gel, you know? I would say, is it the gel? I would put a lot of gel, but then my hair wouldn't move. So, and after that, the only other person who did it as well as you is Manish Malhotra, because his hair also looks. So was it gel or was it water? No, for you, not him. Gel or water?
No, actually, it's spirit gum. No, honestly, it's a spirit gum. So you go back home tonight and put it in your hair and sleep. And in the morning, when you take a bath, it'll look just like that.
It'll still look the same?
Exactly the same. Kal tu dekhna, tu mujhe phone karke kaha, main Manish Malhotra lag raha hun.
I'm going to try, but he is a good looking man, so I'm cool with that. So, coming back to what I'm supposed to say. Yeah. So when Kuch Kuch Hota Hai, sorry. I mean, it's an informal thing only, na, this event. I'm just thinking. I mean, I know Jitesh Pille is here, but none of us are getting awards today, so. So anyway, so I was 11 years old when Kuch Kuch Hota Hai released. Ironically, on the same day, my dad's film released called Bade Mia Chote Mia. And thank you, there's one person who loved that movie. Kuch Kuch Hota Hai, it had a huge impact on me. And at the cost of not aging Karan and not getting beaten up with him, I think I have two father figures in my life. One is David Dhawan and one is Karan Johar. And I'm very grateful, Karan, that you made this film, because this did change my life. So besides these two father figures in my life, there's another person who's really impacted me, and that's the movie star, the mega star, Salman Khan. Let's hear it for him, guys.
Kuch Kuch Hota Hai ke liye release hokar. To Kuch Kuch Hota Hai ka chakkar ye tha ke Karan Johar sahab mere sister se mile और अलवीरा से और उनसे कहा कि ये मेरी फर्स्ट फिल्म है, काजोल को साइन किया है, शाहरुख को साइन किया है, एक छोटा सा रोल है जो कि इम्पोर्टेंट रोल है जो कि कोई स्टार ही करेगा, और उसके लिए मुझे कोई स्टार मिल नहीं रहा है. मेरी सिस्टर अलवीरा ने कहा कि यू नो इज अ रियली गुड गाय एंड हिज फर्स्ट फिल्म एंड आई थिंक यू नो यू शुड हेल्प हिम आउट विद दिस फिल्म. और मुझे एक दिन करण जौहर साहब किसी पार्टी में मिल गए और मैंने उनसे कहा कि आई विल डू इट फॉर माई सिस्टर, फॉर टॉम अंकल, फॉर हीरो आंटी, फॉर करण जौहर, फॉर शाहरुख, आई डिड दिस फिल्म. एंड नॉट ओनली दैट, मुझे स्क्रिप्ट बहुत पसंद आई थी. प्रीटी इम्प्रेस्ड विद करण्स राइटिंग. करण बड़े ही क्लियर उस वक्त भी थे और बड़ी अच्छी पिक्चर बनाई. एक अलग किस्म की फिल्म थी, एक अपना सिग्नेचर स्टाइल, एक अलग ही टाइप का सिनेमा उन्होंने इस्टेब्लिश किया. और टुडे ही इज़ वन ऑफ द मोस्ट सक्सेसफुल प्रोड्यूसर्स डायरेक्टर्स वी हैव इन द इंडस्ट्री. होस्टिंग भी करते हैं, राइटिंग भी करते हैं, एक्टिंग भी करते हैं. तो आई थिंक करण जौहर टुडे इज़ द बिजीएस्ट मैन इन द फिल्म फ्रेटर्निटी. तो आई एम वेरी हैप्पी फॉर करण एंड आई एम हैप्पी टू बी अ पार्ट ऑफ कुछ कुछ होता है. And may this film remain an inspiration to all the young filmmakers, directors, and Shahrukh, love you, best of luck. And Karan, best of luck and keep on doing great work. And someday work with me again.
Mujhe iske saath film karni hai. I think we had made Duplicate, yeah, which hadn't done as well as we thought it would. And I said, ugly picture, Karan ke saath please karte hain. Mr. Bhatt, actually has so many common things with Alia. Mr. Bhatt has never apparently done a film for the same producer twice over, one after the other. And because Duplicate didn't go where it was meant to, I think Bhatt Saab, at that time the topmost director, had agreed to do it. And Tom Uncle was very keen ki, Biradar, wo Bhatt Saab kar rahe hain ek aur hamare saath. To ye wali karni hai kya pehle? To I said, nahin. पिक्चर तो मुझे करण के साथ ही करनी है बिकॉज आई स्पेंड टाइम विद ऑन दिल वाले एंड आदि वॉज रियली बिसॉर्टेड विद टू मेनी थिंग्स हैपनिंग ऑन द सेट, टू मेनी पीपल, फर्स्ट फिल्म फॉर एवरी वन. एंड आई काइंड ऑफ नोटिस्ड हाउ क्वाइटली, स्वीटली एंड विद अ ग्रेट सेंस ऑफ ह्यूमर एंड ईज करण यूज टू बी असिस्टिंग आदि टू गेट द फिल्म राइट. मोस्ट ऑफ द डायलॉग स्टफ दैट आई डिड इन दिल वाले, आदि वुड टेल मी तू जा करण के साथ कर ले, देन करण वुड कम डाउन एंड यू नो वी वुड फिगर आउट हाउ टू डू द लाइन्स विद द रेस्ट ऑफ द एक्टर्स ऑल्सो. एंड आई रियलाइज दैट he has a strange honest spark in him and I like people with a sense of humor. I get bored by serious people. Adi is the only serious people I love actually, but invisible Adi. And he came and he narrated a story to me, and everyone should know the story he narrated to me during in that hotel on the steps of Chahat shoot was crap and nonsense, utterly not like the film that you finally saw. And in his own way, that Karan is actually, you know, man of many words and the gift of the gab, and you know, thinking he's impressing everyone, he's got it all right. He actually thought he's impressed me with this crap story. I've never told him. We were sitting on steps like this, and he said, "And then ये होता है और उसके और कुछ नहीं होता था, एकदम बकवास कहानी थी वो." और and he never he till date feels कि मुझे वो याद नहीं है वो कहानी क्या थी. And then he of course came with Kajol and both of them just kept crying in my room. Aur fir Anjali. And then when he would stop and narrate ki, and in the next scene bhai. So I heard nothing. I heard two imbeciles crying and could not
in
make
our defense
out.
We really thought that we were making a fabulous film, and when Karan narrated the script to me, I was like, each and every scene, I was feeling like, oh my God, this is so cool. It's going to be so cool when we do it.
And so I didn't know the story then. I didn't realize the story when we did Chahat narration. I didn't understand the story when Kajol and Karan narrated it to me. And like Twinkle, I'm glad, like, you know, she didn't do the film and she thinks that helped the film. I'm glad I didn't hear the story and just went ahead with what Karan believed in. Otherwise, it would not be as great a film as it is, because with my inputs, this would be trash. So thank you, Karan, for not making me hear your film.
I remember going to every lead actress for the part that Rani did, starting after Tina. And actually, Tina is not the one who called me and told me that she wasn't doing it. It was her mother who called me. And I still remember, I was, so she didn't even actually call me. Her mother called me and I was still at the Shamiana at the Taj, and she said that, you know, Tina is not comfortable doing the film, and I remember feeling very shattered. After that, of course, I went to many girls. I went to, I think, every lead actress that there was at that time. There were seven of them. And ironically, Aditya Chopra called me and he said that, "Tune short dekhi hai is picture mein, Raja ki aayegi barat. Usme wo karti hai, aise kya karti hai? She said, wo gaati hai, Raja ki aayegi barat." So I said, "Wo tu dekh le, jis tarah wo karti hai na, wo superstar hai." So I said, "Kaise kiya usne?" He said, "Main nahi bata sakta, tu trailer dekh le." So I said, "Okay." And then Shah Rukh had also seen the same shot. So I said, "Why are these two men after this one girl who has done this one shot called Raja Ki Aayegi Barat?" And anyway, by that time, every lead actress available in the fraternity had said no to me. And I said, "I might have to wear that short skirt and do the role," because nobody was left. And then I went to Rani, and I didn't realize how short she was till I reached the house. And when I opened the door, she opened the door, I had to look and say, "Oh, hello." and it was Rani. And then there was Nikhil and Tarun with me, the ADs on the film, and they were sitting on the side. And I narrated the first half because that was all that there was, barring one, and the first half. And then she said, "Can you come to my room?" So I got nervous because nobody, no girl had ever asked me to come to their room before. And so I was like, "Okay, I'll come." What happened? And she told me in the room that, "How are you going to convince an audience?" I don't want to say it next to your assistants, but how are you going to convince everybody that Shah Rukh likes me over Kajal? Because they were the eternal love pair. And I said, "Just trust me and go with it." And Rani, do you remember that?
I do remember that. And I do remember crying also after narration. So I also cried. I think it was your sincerity, and you were so cute and fat that time.
Yeah, thanks.
And I really miss you like that. Uh-huh. Though everybody likes you like this, yeah. But I miss you like that.
Well, he's and gone till you haven't grown taller, darling.
And also, I think everybody thinks that I'm a Yash Raj heroine, but actually the first family I made in the industry was Dharma. So thank you, Karan. Thank you, Hiro Aunty.
For everybody, I always tell you that. What do you mean? I take full credit for you, Rani. Don't.
So I think the love that I got from them was very special, because I was a newcomer then. And what was special about Yash Uncle and Karan at that time was that though they were two big stars in the film, they never treated me unequally. And I thought that was very special, because I had no idea how newcomers are treated. But the kind of love and the kind of attention that I got from Karan, that was very, very touching. And I always remember that. Till date. And that's why I love you, Karan, and you're special.
I love you, Rani. And I still remember Rani
snatching my plate of breakfast.
Oh, God. Yeah.
He has harassed me in the movie. I remember.
No, I just told
you. He's really special. He's feeling very special right now.
He has harassed me because he has snatched my plate of food, which I was eating in the morning, of the shot that keeps coming in the trailer, which is my orange short top and short skirt. And I remember Manish and Karan walking by, and I was sitting with, I think, the junior artist, and I was eating my breakfast, and they both looked at me and gone, "Huh? You can't eat that. Remove the plate from my hand. Remove the plate from my hand." And they actually snatched my plate, and then Manish became like very nice and said, no, you can't snatch a plate. Give the food back to her.
No, we called the room service and said not to give you food. Because that time she was supposed to be the bomb in college, and she had to lose weight, and she ended up putting on weight and coming to Mauritius. And then we were like, "How are these clothes?" With Manish had bought these really stretched fabric kind of things, and we were like, "How are they going to fit her?"
So no, but I think you should tell them the story about my mom in the outdoor, from whom actually Manish went, and I think you should narrate the story.
It was the funniest.
It's really funny. And of course, the Koi Mil Gaya costume.
That Koi Mil Gaya costume. So when Manish made the Koi Mil Gaya costume, it was a spandex silver dress, which was, it's a stretch fabric on a hanger. It looks really tiny. So we went to the DOP, Santosh Tundial, and I said, "This is the," he's saying, "for baby?" So he thought it was for that small Sana. He said, "This is for baby?" So I said, "No, this is for Rani." And then he stared at it and thought we had lost the plot because it was this tiny. But anyway, subsequently, of course, it looked really good on Rani and we managed it. But that other story was about the, well, that was funny because she was meant to be a sequence in...
No, that actually shows what a good costume designer Manish was actually.
No, because Krishna aunty, her mother, used to always go out to sleep in the van. Because bus. The locations were high. She used to, in the bus.
Yeah.
She used to fall out to sleep. It was a bus that those days we didn't have individual vans. We used to go together. And she was supposed to be a Mangal Sutra Rani to wear. It was a flash. It was a cut that was supposed to insinuate that she's already married. So I had told Manish, I'll need a Mangal Sutra, but Manish had forgotten. So of course, he didn't want to tell me that he had forgotten. So he went running to the bus and woke up Krishna aunty and said, Mujhe apna Mangal Sutra de do. So Krishna aunty was like, "Main nahi dungi apna Mangal Sutra." So, because he was just wondering why Manish Malhotra is asking for a Mangal Sutra in the middle of the day. "Nahi dungi," and he had to pull and yank on the Mangal Sutra, and of course come up, and it happened to have an orange bead in it, which also happened to be the color of Rani's sari at that time. So Manish, full performance has come and said, "Here, this is the Mangal Sutra. And see, I matched it to her sari." Actually, he had done no such thing. He has given it to me short. Then after the shot is over, I turn around and I see huffing and puffing Krishna aunty charging up that slope for her Mangal Sutra, her Suhaag ki nishani. And then she even told me, "Wo hamara Suhaag le gaya." And I was like, what does she mean? Like, what happened there? And then I realized it was there. But anyway, there were such funny stories. Kajal, of course, we tortured you a lot also with your wig and your clothes. And we tried to get that. Mickey was traumatized the first schedule when you had to wear that bob cut because you refused to cut your hair. And you didn't.
Excuse me. What would have happened to that huge big shot that you had of, oh, slow motion mein turn karna?
Well, that second half mein tha na.
Yeah, but I would have grown my hair by that time.
Yeah, but did you get as tortured as Bhai says that you cried right through the film, but you did not cry on
No, I didn't cry. I only remember one thing where y'all were really nasty to me and y'all tried to convince me that I was a junior artist.
No, that was Bhai will tell you when
both of y'all tried very hard to convince me that I was a junior artist as a backup dancer.
But Bhai will tell you the story. It was in Mauritius in that cycle sequence what happened to Kajal. Yeah.
First he threw me off the bike so that I fell and hit my head. You did.
I
see the story
I treat women like this only. Yeah. But we were to do a cycle thing, and I think Kajol is not very good at cycling. And you know, so we were supposed to ride and leave hands or something. And she had been practicing, and then suddenly she slipped right in front of me. The whole handle turned, and she went flying, and she landed like this on the ground.
On her head, yeah.
On her head, like thup, like that. And because Kajol laughs at everything, then we also naturally laugh at everything, even. Yeah.
What has that got to do with it?
Because he laughs, so we also, and then we went and kind of picked her up and realized it was a little serious. And like, you know, in comic books, you have those little bees and birds and flying. So she like this. And amazingly, she had short-term amnesia. She had lost her memory.
And she truly did. She forgot.
Truly did. First we thought, you know, it's the shock because she's like, what? She didn't even, I mean, later on I'll tell you, she didn't even recognize Ajay when we called him and said.
Liar. You had no idea.
You had no idea. No, honestly, we called up Ajay to say, and then he called Ajay and all. But she forgot everyone. And we took her to the room, and I think we tried to give her some, like, something like Advil of that time or whatever, paracetamol, something. And she had actually lost her memory, and she didn't know who she was, who she was with, what she was doing here. And it was really funny if it wasn't so serious. Actually, it was funny. It wasn't serious at all. And at one point in time, I thought maybe we should now convince her that she's somebody else. So even if she never wakes up from this amnesia, then she will always be that person.
Be the backup dancer, basically.
So we kind of told her because, you know, she, me and Kajal both have this issue. We can't dance well. And so I just thought to just, you know, some quirky, weird sense of humor that, you know, maybe if I convince her she's a backup dancer, so when she comes round to it, maybe she'll become a better dancer. Or something like that. It was out of
He convinced her that she's a background dancer.
Background dancer. Out of goodness of my heart to improve your dancing, I just did that. And see, ever since then, have you noticed some of the steps you're getting a little? But she came back. I think a couple of hours of sleep. And then she sort of... and it was afterwards very scary, to be honest, that she genuinely lost her memory. Yeah.
I still remember the very first day we shot the song Koi Mil Gaya, and Rani was the only one who had rehearsed the song. She had rehearsed it for 15 days because she also had the time at that point. And they were shooting, and so she rehearsed the song, and Kajal and Shah Rukh came. They were the superstars, and they walked in and whatever. And Farah was being Farah, and the step started, and they played that Koi Mil Gaya, that song, that step Koi Mil Gaya. And finally, Kajal looked and she's saying, because Rani was doing something totally different. So Kajal looked and said, what is she doing? She's doing it all wrong. And from loud, like the voice of God, Farah said, she is doing it right. Y'all both are doing rubbish.
One girl and holding the other. And then I am lustfully and very, I'm very cheaply looking at this girl whose sari's pallo flies off. Very creepy.
It's objectification, it's wrong.
It seemed really wrong, and I'm...
And also, actually, it's quite a fraudulent statement you made, which you didn't live up to. You said, "Hum ek hi baar jeete, ek baar marte, pyar bhi ek hi baar hota hai, shaadi." But you fell in love twice, you got married twice, so you were, actually, your whole philosophy was fraudulent.
No, but then I added, "Kuch kuch hota hai, Anjali, tum nahi samjhoge." Aisa tha wo. Wo maine cover up kar liya tha, aisa nahi tha. But yeah, my memory would be, I don't know how to describe this memory because it will involve all of you. Especially Karan, you know, whenever I think of Karan Johar, it'll always be attached to the fact that he made me participate in a film out of his love, more than out of the script. And I remember Tom Uncle always telling me, "Beta, ye kya kar raha hai?" And he used to get sometimes, as a father, more than the producer, you know, worried, is he getting it right? And I would always, without knowing myself actually, whether he'll get it right or not, used to be the guy who would tell Tom Uncle, ki, "Tom Uncle, ye bahut achha karega." As you know, that's the only way you can counter it. You can't agree with him and come to him, because the one thing that was very clear about Karan was he was, like somebody said, you know, he had this very pure emotion. I think Farah mentioned it in an interview. The purity of emotion at that point in time to write this beautiful, innocent love story and live with it and carry it along. Not be affected, as a matter of fact, with established actors like myself, Kajol, and even Rani, and the others. You know, we had Archana, we had Anupam, we had Himani Ji, we had Farida Jalal, so many senior actors around him. But he did not succumb to catering to any part, to anyone else, except to the truth of his story. So to me, the greatest memory is this young boy, and it is extremely encouraging for all the youngsters who are working with Karan. I think take that one thing away from him, whether it's Ishan, Janvi, Varun, tu to ab young Rani, jail lagayega to acha ho jayega subah. Siddharth and all the young boys and girls who Dharma is honing up and training and making them such wonderful stars and actors. The one thing that you need to take away from Karan is the honesty to telling the story that you want to tell. So for me, the biggest memory and the biggest learning, apart from the love and every 10 years, inshallah, when we meet for Kuch Kuch Hota, or any other, the other day also when we were shooting for a film together, Kajol Rani, I am one extremely lucky to get kissed on my both cheeks simultaneously every time I meet Kajol and Rani. No man in the world has that luck. So thank you for Kuch Kuch Hota for that. So I got it tonight also. Thank you, ladies, for being so kind and kissy. And of course, like I said, my biggest memory would be that Karan has taught me how to be honest to your work, how to continue doing what you believe in, and keep the innocence, retain the innocence of what you want to say in a film, a story, in a poem. And Tina and me just pointed out, we were just thinking that, you know, when he came on stage with your ill-fitting suit for that Filmfare Award, and now, such wonderful clothes you wear. It's stunning what you are dressed up as.
It's really stunning.
It's really nice. You know, 40 years from now, when we come for Kuch Kuch Hota again, we'll have to make a similar kind of comment. Who made these pants?
That's my Sindhi legacy. I have to wear.
But
shine.
I want to know what's written. Is Kuch Kuch Hota written?
No, it says Philip.
Hashtag KKH.
No, it's not.
All right. So, like he said, you know, he came on stage that he would have to wait. And I think even Kareena mentioned it, that he'd have to wait for years or become a compare to hold the mic on the Filmfare stage. It's so strange that being, according to me, not even arguably, according to me, honestly, the greatest director this country has produced in modern times. I think he should make more cinema as a director. He should write more films. It's not my memories. It's what I really would love to see in my lifetime and my children's lifetimes and all the youngsters, that if Karan Johar can make lot more movies, not like Kuch Kuch Hota necessarily, whatever he feels like, because the one thing I learned from Karan is, if you feel it right, you can't go wrong. So make us feel more right with more beautiful films like this. And thank you very much for teaching me that through Kuch Kuch Hota Hai. Thank you.
And Kajol, do you have a last memory you want to share with us? Or
I think everybody's praised you enough now.
No, not me. I said the film. I'm not talking about me.
Oh, thanks. I'm very upset with you. We'll have this chat later.
No, Kajol has been saying, why am I not having more fun on this show? So I'm like,
this
have
is,
to be a little more
I mean,
serious.
It's, no, it's not a personal show at all. I mean, like, you know, we thought that we were coming for like a 20-year get-together of Kuch Kuch Hota Hai.
Kajol, this is now, we are older. We have to be more elegant. Like Farida ji just walked in and Farida ji will tell you how much... And she's been tortured enough by you in all those movies, so we just decided to keep
Anybody
it cool.
Anybody wants to crack a dirty joke?
No.
Okay.
You have anything to say, Kajol, or should I move on?
Move on.
All right, okay. Rani, you have a last memory.
I think I've said this several times in my interviews. The thank you, Shah Rukh, for teaching me how to romance on screen. There's nobody.
Can you praise my tight T-shirts?
No. No. I just love your heart. I think Shah Rukh has
and
immense
we
can
see
love.
It very clearly in the tight T-shirt.
Yes.
With my nipples.
So I don't think there's anybody who can romance like Shah Rukh on screen, and I feel very blessed and lucky to have been one of his heroines who he's loved, because when Shah Rukh loves, I don't think there's anybody who loves like Shah Rukh. So thank you, Shah Rukh, for being so lovely. And I do remember...
Blush!
I do remember when we shot for the song in Scotland. I don't know whether you remember the Shah Rukh, but because it was my first romantic film, there were shots where Shah Rukh was supposed to kiss me on the cheek, and I remember going, shifting my weight to the other side because I was so young and I was so naive, I guess. I don't know.
She was 17 years old when she shot Kuch Kuch Hota
Hai.
19.
17.
17.
Yeah.
Oh, God.
So...
I didn't know that.
So thank you, Shah Rukh, for making me feel so loved and teaching me actually how it is to romance on screen. So thank you so much. I couldn't have it better in my career than to have Shah Rukh Khan romance me and teach me how to romance. So thank you.
And two people I suggested Rani to. One was Karan, and she became the Dharma heroine. One was Adi, who married her. So my recommendation.
You've done very well.
100%.
You've done very well.
And of course, Kajal Didi, thank you for always... helping me at times when I got stuck. And I do remember those days. Yes, you did. No, I think you forgot.
Kajal helped you when?
I don't remember that.
No,
what
you
I
do
I
remember.
I also don't remember when she helped you.
I do
just
remember.
Shut up now. Let
Since
me talk
it's 20
now,
years of Kuch Kuch Hota, I have to say these things.
Let me just tell you something about Rani. Since we're on this stage, I have to say that the one thing that she never asked for was help. She came... She stood in front of all of us, in front of a Shah Rukh Khan, in front of me, in front of Karan, never showed, yes, she may have been nervous off screen, but never showed that on screen. Stood over there, gave her shot like a star, wore the shortest skirts like a star, walked across, walked across the whole of that mind-blowing college that nobody ever knew existed before Karan Johar showed us on screen.
It was not a college, but...
Whatever it was, shut up. It was on checkered floor or whatever. But she walked very beautifully off along that corridor in high speed. May I just tell you that it's very difficult to walk in high speed in such high heels in a short skirt. So, awesome.
And I love you, Kajal Didi. I love you, Shah. And Karan, I don't need to tell you how much I love you.
And it's all about loving each other. And now that we have finished telling each other how much we love each other, I just want to thank everyone
and
here.
Yes, of course, Tina. Thank you for not doing the film. I love you.
Tina will always be...
All the eight heroines who said no to the film.
Tina, thank you.
Tina
is omnipresent in the journey of Kuch Kuch Hota Hai. She has been really right through.
And ironically, Tina became a very close friend in the times to come. So I think Kuch Kuch Hota actually have made a huge family. And Gauri Ma, I have to tell you, in Mauritius, Abraham was 1 year old. Aryan was 1 year old. And I used to play with him in the lobby with him and the nanny.
You played?
Aryan was born
during Kuch Kuch Hota.
Aryan was born after Koi Mil Gaya finished shooting.
Yes.
We finished on the 10th of November, he was born on the 12th.
Yeah, and I remember going down and playing with Aryan in my arms. And I think Shah Rukh have played with both your kids and now with Abraham as well. So.
Exactly.
That's one thing I have to say about you. You produce very good looking children.
Yeah. Yeah. Well done. Genetic power.
And I love you, Gauri Ma, as well.
Thank you.
Gauri, you're taking the credit for this one.
Well, Gauri, you actually thought that we would be thanking you today on this film. What have you got to do with this?
No, I think Gauri was very, very instrumental.
The only thing Gauri did is she kept Aryan in till that first schedule finished. I was like, please don't deliver. My schedule will go for a toss. That was the one thing that I kept praying for.
No, but Gauri's always been an encouragement all the time. So thank you, Gauri Ma, for being there always for us.
Yay. All right. Thank you, Rani. Thank you, Shahrukh. Thank you, Kajal. And thank you to everyone present from Dharma Productions. Thank you. And I have to say that, like, right now, things are so different for us at Dharma than they were. And I have to thank Apurva for that. He's really structured the new enterprise in such a majestic and an organized fashion. And all the directors and the producers.